Hi friends, welcome to EduTap. So welcome to the Everyday at 5 series brought to you by EduTap for IBPS AFO 2018-19. So this is lecture number 13 and it is Agricultural Engineering Part 5. Now this is a series wherein each day we come up with a certain MCQs and we discuss some of the important concepts of agriculture. Now friends, I've been getting comments that you want me to cover animal husbandry and fisheries. So we will also do the same once we are done with Agricultural Engineering, right? And let us begin with today's lecture. So before that, what are the courses that EduTap offers for IBPS AFO for 2018-19? So we have a full video course which includes tests as well, and it includes the concept videos, notes, summary sheets, worksheets, MCQs for each of the topics in agriculture. Along with that, we have 25 full and 10 tests as well as 25 sectional tests, and all this can be availed for a price of ₹2499 for a limited period. And we also have a test series separately which includes 25 full length mock tests as well as 25 sectional tests, and that particular test series can be availed for ₹1499. And friends, we need to know that the notification is out. You can find it on the IBPS website, and the dates are for prelims 29th and 30th of December, and for mains it is 27th of January 2019. So friends, first let us discuss the answers for the questions that we put forth as part of the previous lecture, right? So the question number one was, which of the following is the functions of a planter? So you need to know that planter is a farm equipment, okay, and it's an implement which we will discuss about in the coming section. And what are the functions of it? So is it used to open the furrow only? Is it used to meter the seed, to deposit the seed in the furrow, to cover the seed and compact the soil over the seed? So it performs all the above mentioned functions. This is a very important question. So you need to know that these are the functions. Basically, it is called multitasking as well. So it saves a lot of time and it is accurate as well. So let us see, what is a planter? So basically it is a sowing equipment, okay, it is used for sowing the seeds which are larger in size. This is important, so kindly keep this in mind. So the smaller seeds are usually handled by seed drills. We will also see some of the questions on seed drills in the coming lectures, okay. And it has a lot of advantages where using a planter when you are sowing the seeds, it helps us to maintain row to row and plant to plant spacing. So if you can, if you would have subscribed to our course, there is a chapter of basics of agriculture wherein we study a lot of concepts in agronomy. So there is a concept which is called plant geometry, okay, wherein we concentrate upon the spacing that exists between a plant to plant, okay, as well as row to row, okay. So R into R, that is represented by, and P into P. So there are questions on this plant spacing as well. That is why when we were going through the horticulture videos as part of this series, we made sure that we are keeping in mind the spacing that is required in important fruit crops, okay. Now there are different types of planters, like you have potato planter, maize planter, cotton planter, okay. So these are the commonly used equipments, and as we have just seen, these are the functions of a planter that is usually performed. So the second question is, what is the required depth of for placement of nitrogenous fertilizer in paddy field, okay? So that there is no loss of the fertilizer that we are adding, so it is adequately utilized, okay? So the depth which is usually considered suitable is 15 to 20 centimeter. So kindly make note of it. It's a factual question, okay? So you need to memorize this fact. Moving on to the third question, what is the volume of liquid handled by the high volume sprayer, okay? Now friends, talking about sprayers, so this is one of the plant protection equipments. So if you see nowadays, because of the advanced technologies, mostly around the year we see that a particular field bears crops, one or the other. So because of that longevity, there are a lot of diseases as well that have come into existence, a lot of pests that exist, okay. So we need to frequently make sure that we are applying certain herbicides, we are applying certain fungicides, pesticides. So for all those things we have certain equipments, okay. They can be applied in the form of sprays, and the equipment that is used to apply them is known as sprayer. We can apply the fertilizers or the pesticides, fungicides, insecticides in the form of dust as well. Okay, so we use dusters as well. So now let us have a look at sprayer. So based on the volume of liquid that it handles, there's a classification among under this sprayer. Okay, so we will see what is that classification. So in this question, they asked about high volume sprayer. So the answer to this question is more than 400 liter per hectare. So this is the volume that it can handle. So kindly memorize this. It's an important question. So here you can see that it is a machine to apply fluids in the form of droplets. We are spraying fluids. Okay, now these sprayers are used for multiple purposes. You can use it for applying fungicides to eliminate or minimize fungal diseases, right? Application of herbicides, okay, to remove weeds, right? Application of insecticides to control insect pest. Application of micronutrients on the plant, so you can use for this purpose as well. Now again, we can see that based on the volume of liquid that it can handle, the sprayers are classified into three categories. You can have a look at it here. One is a high volume spray. We have just now seen that it handles more than 400 liters per hectare. Then there is low volume spray, 5 to 400 liters per hectare. When it goes less than 5 liters per hectare, it is called ultra low volume sprayer. Okay, so ULV sprayer. This is important. Okay, so kindly make note of this classification. This is important. Next, the last one that we'll discuss, what is the application rate for hand atomizer? Okay, now these sprayers that we were discussing about, they can either be manually operated, they can be engine operated, okay, even they can be airplane operated. Okay, using airplanes also we actually spray various insecticides, fertilizers or fungicides in the crop field. Okay, so now under manually operated sprayers, one of the example is hand atomizer. In the next lecture, we will actually have a look at the list of the manually operated sprayers. So one of it is hand atomizer, and this particular equipment is ideally suited for home gardens and small fields. Okay, so the application rate is 45 to 100 liter per hectare. Okay, this is important. Just keep in mind. Now coming to the questions that you need to answer for today. So, okay, let me just put forth one other question before I start off with these questions. So we were just mentioning about three types of sprayers. One is manually operated, engine operated, or aircraft driven or operated. Now you need to give me at least two examples, okay, apart from hand atomizer, of the manually operated sprayers. Okay, so you need to tell me two names, and please mention the answers in the comment section below. We need to make the series interactive. So now the first question, apart from this, what I've just asked you, that two examples of manually operated sprayers, what is the pressure which is required to operate hand compression sprayer? Okay, so again, this is one of the examples of manually operated. So two eliminated already. You're not allowed to use hand compression sprayer and the hand atomizer. Apart from this, you need to give me two names. Okay, now what is the pressure which is required to operate this hand compression sprayer? You need to give me the answer. The pressure is also important, because based upon that only we decide what is going to be the mode of application, right? Next comes the question, the capacity of hand operated knapsack sprayer is what? Okay, so you need to give me an answer for this as well. We are talking about capacity. Now whenever we are dealing with equipments, you need to know its capacity, because it is important. Okay, the third question for today, the pressure required to operate foot or pedal sprayer is how much? Okay, so again, we are talking about pressure. So you can now infer, or you can just deduce two things from here. Then when we are dealing about sprayers, there are two parameters that you need to know. Okay, one parameter is the pressure of application, And the next is about the capacity. So if you know the pressure and capacity of each of the examples of sprayers, then obviously your work is done. Okay, so you might get a question among all these things. Okay, so the pressure which is required to operate foot or pedal sprayers is how much? So you need to give me this answer. Okay, so the last question for today that you need to answer is which of these are the functions of combine. Okay, so this is a very important, or you can say in trend these days, this equipment. So is it used for cutting the standing crops? Is it used for feeding the cut crops with a threshing unit? Is it used for threshing the crops? Or is it used to cleaning the grains, freeing it from straw? So is combine used for all these operations mentioned above? So you need to tell me which is the correct option for this particular question. So friends, with this we have come to the end of this particular lecture. So if you have any query regarding our courses, you can visit our website www.edutab.co.in. You can also drop us a mail at hello@edutab.co.in, and you can give us a call at 814-620-7241. So friends, we will also be discussing some of the numericals as the day passes. We will also deal with those, and kindly let me know that how useful is the series going on. We need to get the feedback from you guys. Only then we'll be able to work harder and come up with the changes that you want us to make. And if you really found this video useful, kindly like, subscribe and share. And if you want to download the PDF format of this particular lecture, that also can be done from EduTab's Telegram channel. The link for the channel is placed on your screens, and you can find the link in the comment section of this particular video as well. Till then, friends, thank you so much. Keep revising and happy learning.